You know what's great?
Dogs barking in the background.
You know what else is great?
Acne.
You know what else is great? Being terrible at focusing. I have no idea if I'm in focus or not. I'm probably way out of focus. The background is probably in focus, and I look like some sort of blurry demon thing. Instead of just, if I was in focus, in which case I would just look like a not blurry demon thing, I guess. I'm borrowing some lenses, so that's cool. Yay. So, these are computers that need to be worked on, and I probably look terrible because I had to drop the aperture, and now I don't. Everything is awful. Anyway, computers. So, there's actually some pretty cool stuff here. There's this Cooler Master case, which I can't. There we go. It does. It's like. Oh god. Oh god. Destroying everything. Anyway, it's fancy and giant. It's full ATX. The only full ATX case I've worked with, actually. And then there's a Dell thing and an HP thing below it. Neither of them are particularly exciting. One of them has a Pentium. This one has what? Oh, i5? That's pretty cool. I wonder which i5. I wonder why people must talk so background noise. What is this? What? Is this a fan shroud? Sure, let's say it's a fan shroud. I don't know. Nice looking SATA cables. I have to imagine they're three big gigabit only. Revision A. It is very, very rare that a revision A of anything is particularly nice to use. Should do just like an anectic power supply commentary here. That is a reference one person is going to get. What the heck? Oh, well, there goes that dim. 1 gigabyte of edge. This is a Reaper main. Okay, I have a monitor hooked up, I don't have a keyboard or mouse, but whatever. Power button, there it is. Did you hear that? And that? It post? Just did, though? The most common reason for the memory size being different is the removal. But, I mean, thank you for this information. If I remember removing memory from the system board, it's most likely I know I removed memory from the system board. I just dropped RAM from really high, and This is PS2, so I need to restart. Even though this is functioning, I may not use it for much. I do not know what that grind noise is, though. Oh, the Model M works with it. That's nice. That's always nice. Okay, alright. I made a mistake. That's out of focus. There we go. Fixed. Just gonna live change my camera angles while I wait for this to do stuff. Non-system disk or disk error. What is a non-system disk? I mean, I know what a non-system disk is, but... What? Okay. That is exactly what it should be doing. So, one of the three computers was supposed to be functional, and apparently it's this one. So, out of the three, it's the one with a bloody Pentium. Okay. It's really loud, actually. Like, I'm not sure if you can hear that over the monitor outside, or the people running up and down the stairs. Why is there a lawnmower outside? That is my real question. It's, like... There's a lawnmower. Why is there a lawnmower?
I don't know.
Why is there someone knocking on my door? Hold on. You know what? I'm just gonna make this entire video nonsense. People interrupting. And he's gone. Okay. What the heck do you want?
I was just knocking because you were commenting on all the noise. But it's
new. Apparently he was just knocking to annoy me. Okay. All of this is going in the video, and this did this too fast, and I never found out. Seriously, what is with the lawnmower? Just done with that! I almost saw it. One of these days. Please stop that. Boot me, F10. Dyslexia, I can't read fast enough. Beep. 301 keyboard error. What? System info. What is this? System information about. What? Okay. Flash system ROM. Replicate. What? Oh, that's kind of cool, actually. So you can... This is clearly supposed to be a workstation machine, because you can replicate from a drive. You can replicate... Well, that's not focus. You can replicate things. Yes, English. Good job. Default setup. Storage. Drive configuration. Pseudo default. Okay. Alright, don't care. Nope. I don't even know what I'm doing here. Drawing options. Execute memory test. Onboard memory test. Cool. BIOS power on. Automatic power on. That's cool. PCIe devices. Select PCIe device from are accused, disable or disable the device. There we go. The system settings may not take effect for operating systems to hide the device from OS. See security device security. Oh, apparently you can hide devices from the OS. This is OS power management, hardware power management, thermal. Look at that!
You can't see it because somehow this is way out of focus. Look at that! Don't know how this keeps getting out of focus. I keep focusing it. Hold on. Oh, you can't zoom while recording. Okay, then Nikon, you're stupid. Anyway,
I could change. Why can't I do that in the Dell? Nope. That's not what I intended. Please. That wasn't fast enough. No, I was. What files, system information. There we go. DC 5700 micro tower. This is a micro tower? Pentium D! Look at that! Pentium D 2160. At 1.8 gigahertz. Why is there so much noise outside? A gig of DDR2. XM1 and X. What? It goes 1. Huh. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4 instead of. 1, 2, 3, 4 instead of 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. You couldn't even see that hand movement because I was above frame. I'm stupid. Anyway, it's 1, 2, 3, 4 instead of 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, upside down though. System BIOS. Something, some nonsense. Chassis serial number. Don't care. Asset tracking number. Don't care. About. Now, what is the difference between about and system information? System and BIOS setup utility. Just about is just system and BIOS setup utility and, like, copyright. What? HP what? Press any key to continue. Where is the any key? How do you leave? There we go. Apply defaults and exit. Are you sure you want to... Okay. Well, it works. So, I guess I'll see if I can replace the fan shroud, and then... murder someone. Hold on. Where are you trying to stop? Okay. All of these computers have an ESMA. Okay, I'm gonna be able to use. Yes! All of the computers I have to work on have PS2 ports, which means I don't have to deal with the membrane. Yay. CDW. Look at that. It was Windows Vista. What? Designed for Microsoft Windows XP. And it's got a Vista OS tag. Alright, cool. I will be back. Because people are yelling at me. Alright, I've returned. You know, the lighting is terrible. But if I put the ISO higher, then there's fuzz. Because if I put the ISO higher, though, I can drop the aperture down. There. That look better? Not really. Whatever. Okay. And apparently there's a countdown timer for something I don't understand. New camera. Alright, let's swap this out. You know what? It's time-lapse time.
Okay, this is actually like a
bistro, and I'm very happy because it means it's a consumer deal, which means consumer PCI Express slot locks instead of the stupid ones they use in Optiplexes. Way better. Anyway, I know this because I just had to install a graphics card because I think I removed one along with like several other PCIe cards. Yeah, I can't exactly remember. Anyway, they were like in the way or something. And this, oh, that's a 6-pin. Look at that. That's a graphics 6-pin. This must have been one of the models that could also come with like i7s and stuff. Anyway, where's the power button? Yay, power button. Whoa, that is a lot of speed on those fans. Good forward. Come on. Hey, it posts. Hooray. Sort of. Oh, crap, I need a keyboard. I wonder what I dropped in my Model M. It's not the click mechanism or anything, right? I just almost did a bad. That would have killed some motherboards right there. It is not USB. That's weird. I think caps lock didn't illuminate. Let's go back and look at that footage. That was really odd. Cool. What? Come on. Seriously, why does it do that? Why do you have to be a basic Dell thing? It's funny, Optiplexes, some old Optiplexes do that, but most of the modern ones don't. They run the fan at full speed when they first post because for some... What? Why? How? Seriously, I want to know what that is. It is F12, right? F12 is boot options. F2. I'm dumb. I use Dells every... And loud noises. Hooray. There we go. So one problem with this computer is, hold on, I'll be right back.
Okay, I'm back.
Okay. It did it again! Why? Why would you... And they're still being loud downstairs. I don't actually even know if they can hear you. If you can hear them. I am a good within the English. It's all these really bright lights. I can't speak because of it. What? No. No. That's not... No. Come on. The F2 is gonna be the first thing to go on this model. What? Oh, wait. RIP PS2, I guess. Oh, having it plugged into the mouse port wouldn't really be helping anything now, would it? Good good intelligent things you do in there, Logan. Yeah.
Kill me.
Did you work? Did it work?
Yay! Okay.
Whoa, it's so cool and fancy. Look at this. Look at it. Look at it. Look at it. System information. I'm at 750! It's superior to that. To the i5 Ingenia, actually. At 2.667 gigahertz. It's so specific. 3 gigs of memory installed. What do you got going? Quick boot enabled. Boot up numlock on. It is. HDD production. Leaps disabled. I don't care.
Hey, Dan, I've got an idea. You remember the old game where I think of something and then you ask me questions and guess what it is?
Sure, Eddie, why?
Well, let's play that game.
Okay, you want to start?
All right. I'm thinking of something that's red and blue and yellow and black and white.
I know, a tiger.
Okay, so this one, having a cooler master case and all, is obviously not a pre-built. So, yeah, I don't really know who it was built by. I don't think it was built by the owner. I think it was probably built by a system builder. But it's got one of those old Gigabyte boards that people love to remove the nameplates from, which I'm probably going to do, because I now see why. That's god ugly. But it's AMD. It's other than my laptop, the laptop that a friend has now that I am still taking care of. This lasted a long time. Anyway, other than that, I think this is the only AMD system I've worked on. So, yeah, this is a disaster. Wow, this is a mess. How do you turn it on? Oh, you're not gonna turn it on without plugging it in, now are you, Logan? Brilliant, fabulous work. It has those cable management grommets that go after out the back, or water cooling if that's your thing. What? Lights! It's got an LED fan! It's got a painful thing! It's got LEDs on the front you can't see. Oh, dear Lord, shut up. Well, among the many, many errors it is probably currently having, there's something in the way of... How was this cable managed? What? Optical HDMI. Imagine that. It says optical HDMI on the board, just because it is optical. But imagine, like, HDMI over optical. I guess technically you can do it because, like, optical Thunderbolt. Shut up! Just flip the power supply switch. Yep. That'll work. You know, I just keep saying Cooler Master about this case. I can't actually remember where I got that idea. Oh, okay, it says Cooler Master in the front. And the stupid jaw thing is broken, actually. Don't know exactly how it's broken, but it's definitely broken. So that's fun. Anyway. What is this? That's the case, but it's just... Alright, RAM. I need RAM. So it came... A very loud plane outside. No, it came with fancy RAM, this Corsair XMS2, which is cooler, whatever. pretty sure that was the predecessor to... What's the stuff we use today? It's one good gem. What is that stuff we use today? Dominator. Dominator Platinum. If I remember correctly. Maybe the predecessor to Vengeance. I don't know. Corsair makes a lot of RAM. Corsair makes a lot of stuff. They're a lot easier to install than non-fancy RAM, that's for sure. I've also, like, had them sitting on my desk, and I occasionally just mess with them, so they probably died to static. No? No? What? My monitor's not on, so I'm not getting a post. Oh, look at that! Look at it! It's booting! That was a lot of information on screen just now that I missed. All of it. Speaking of a lot of information on screen... Wow. Disk boot failure. Insert disk system. Disk and press enter. And stuff is off screen there. That's... fabulous. Random controllers. I have never used AMD, so I don't really know what I'm doing. I know that there's background noise now. There's a FireWire port on the top. That's pretty cool. On the, it would be the front panel, but it's on top. What do you want? Wait. Did I just see what I thought I saw? Please. No! I missed it again! Gosh darn it, dyslexia. The disk activity LED is just, like, stuck on. I just realized I have a reset button. I could be taking advantage of that. F9. Oh, I might have killed it. I think the reset button is flawed. Okay then. I guess that cannot. Thank you for that every single time. Can you not, please? Was it F9? Please. Trying so hard. This power button is so satisfying. That's one thing about Cooler Master. They have incredibly satisfying power buttons. I love the one on my, what is it, an S352? Come on. No! So I should probably read that list and make sure F9 was the correct one. Stop making that noise, please. I know what I'm doing. Shut up. I'm good at this. I'm not gonna just murder the computer by boot cycling it over and over and over again. Alright. Where is this? What? F9 is, express recover. So... I didn't actually see a key there. Oh, delete, okay. It's taking forever. Lens looks cool though. Prepare to enter setup. Woohoo! I love how it says prepare to enter setup, not preparing to enter setup. Like, Dells all say preparing to enter setup. No, prepare to enter setup. You are not ready for setup. Hey, that looks familiar. Oh. Intelligent tweaker. You know what that is? Overclocking! Woo! Standard CMOS features, advanced BIOS features, power management setup, PC health status.
hardware thermal control. Don't really know what that means. Disabled. Set open status. CPU warning temperature. CPU fail warning. See if you use my. Current system temperature 30 Celsius, roughly. That is okay. Do you not have. This is a loud system. Good grief. Smart compatibility away mode. Inverted peripherals. Why is there no... Why is there no information here? I don't... Can I find it in here? CPU frequency! 200 megahertz. That's a little... Could change his PCIe clock. That's cool and all. I don't... There's no information here, which means I have to take off the bloody flippin' heatsink to find out anything about the chip. I don't want to do that, because thermal paste is bloody expensive. Why do I keep saying bloody? Quit without saving. Yes. Why are there three keys just to get out of the BIOS? Oh, I don't. Nope. Okay, so there are some cool things in here now that we're done with that debacle. The first thing I immediately notice is, number one, Cooler Master cable management, though. This is a nightmare. Wait a second. This thing. Not entirely certain what it is. At all. Like, it's SATA on one end and then SATA with something else on the other. WD branded. Well, I just realized I couldn't actually see that entire time. Okay, we've got fancy RAM, flying motherboard, not boring, fancy motherboard, and a super fancy CPU of some kind. Although, I'm not to say this is very powerful. This is kind of cool. This is the power supply, of course. It's an 80 plus Silverstone model of some kind. A bit better than some of the other power supplies I know. This is fascinating. Okay, I have to look at these. Yeah. So not only is this like
EVGA Molex. That's not Molex, that's IDE. Molex is just a manufacturer.
I am a smart. We're not a manufacturer. Standards is not. I can. I'm just gonna stop talking. Alright. Okay, this is a human of some kind. Okay. Yep, it's a PCI protector. In case you ever wanted to protect your PCI. PCI, not PCIe. Alright, there is some random nonsense in here. First,
PCI Express power. What is this? I think this is, it's 2 6 pin.
Is that the total?
Yes, it's the total coming off the power supply. What wattage is this power supply? Don't. 500. 500 watt power supply. Okay. That puts it pretty much on par with my brand new EVGA one. Not brand new. Okay. I'm about to do something very, very scary. Actually, you know what?
I'm gonna bring you over here for this.
Alright.
Here we go. I'm gonna move in the way. There it goes.
Attached. Except now we're gonna get that. No, we're not. Yup, we got it. We got the legendary. Old keys problem. Gosh darn it.
There goes
pens.
Yep. But hey. Look at. I can focus. Why? Why won't you? Why are you? No, you're the wrong way. It's okay. There we go. With that, I need a macro lens. This is not working all that well. Anyway, I'm talking straight into the camera, which means I am gonna have a fun time balancing this audio. Yeah, this is. Yeah. Rip. Rip everything. It didn't appear to have pulled any pins off, though. So that's good, at least. Darn it, AMD. Why do you not think your design's through? Alright, let's try to get the CPU off without murdering it. At least we're not trying to deal with an AMD CPU. TM. I got it. That was easy.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I see why that happened. Okay. I think I see AMD Athlon through that. And I'm not entirely sure how one goes about cleaning an AMD CPU. I guess they do it in socket.
And there you go. It's okay. It's fine. Everything is fine. I cannot figure out a way to do this camera angle that doesn't look terrible, so... GG. You get to suffer for it. It's the pen corner. Alright. Why isn't this marked? Who designed this? Fine, I'll just find the... There we go. I'll tell you though, installing an AMD CPU is far more satisfying than an Intel one.
Where is that?
Although installing a giant Xeon, like a 1366 platform thing, is still might be better. There it is. And you can actually see it better than I can, in fact. Just based on my glance at the viewfinder, yeah. Alright. What is this? I'll just read it on the camera. Ready for extremely loud for you macro mode. No, I can't zoom in quite that far. Oh, I'm going backwards, aren't I? What a dumb...
There we go. I still can't read that through the camera. Alright, it's definitely an Athlon 2.
Let me just... You can just look at the back of my head for a second.
And a lot of things. Alright. Hooray! An AMD CPU. And it's... It's pretty gorgeous. Alright, let me get out of there. Look at that. In fact, hold on. Where are my intels?
I just dropped that anyway.
Is that Core 2 Duo? Okay, whatever. So there's the AMD. There's the Intel next to it. See, the AMD is a little larger. It is not an opportune place. Just drop that CPU. See, I dropped this one because... Why can I not get this to macro? Yeah, the pins have been murdered. It doesn't... It's like a mobile... What is this? It's like a mobile Pentium or something. It's copyright, or it's an O2 model, so... Yeah, barely older than me. Or barely younger than me. Okay, I'm gonna put that back because I have no other place to safely put an AMD. Hooray! Okay, so... This case, I'm not sure you ever got a good look at it, but basically it's really weird. And this is, it's upside down right now. The thing is, all its feet are gone. So because this assembly for the weird door thing is up top, it's actually unusable. Yeah, so that's great. Completely unusable. Fabulous. Wonderful. I need to find feet for it. Could just make feet for it, of course. Or just set it up on top of something. And it's, of course, broken. With that part being a problem. I believe this is actual brushed aluminum. Yeah, so it is stained the ever-loving death. What? What did I just say? It's stained to death. Yeah, that's... What? Look at that. SD card reader from what I assume is an HP. It's hilarious. Not just SD, obviously, like... MMC, memory stick. Memory stick slash pro. Good English there. Smart Meteor, XD cards, compact flash 1 and 2. CF 1 and 2. Alright. Case. Let's look up this CPU.
We'll be right back.
Okay, so if you disregard the dogs barking in the background, I'm sorry about that. I'm ready to build a computer. I got this mounted. I may or may not have pulled the CPU out of the socket brutally like 5 times trying to get it mounted because pin grid array, which actually because Intel calls theirs land grid, I really like calling it sky grid because it sounds ridiculous. So I'm going to do that from now on. Let's just call pin grid array sky grid array. And the board also isn't flat anymore. I bent it a little. A lot, actually, just mounting the heatsink. Yeah, AMD boards are not built to do that. Probably should have left the backplate on, but whatever. It may or may not still work. Yay. I need to get a fan on that. I think I'm just going to use the stock AMD fan, even though it's really loud, but I mean it's open air. I've got a LED fan. Cooler Master 1 came out of that really big case. I got a power supply. I would have really loved to use a silver one, but I'm realizing I'm holding this too far forward and it's not in focus. Would have really loved to use a silver one, but this has 8-pin power, but it has an 8-pin, what is that? Is it EPS? I can't remember. 8-pin auxiliary power to the motherboard. And none of the silver power supplies I have 8-pin. They all have just 4-pin, because they're all Intel consumer grade. So, yeah. Time to put a computer in a case, I guess. I've also got broken things here. This stupid thing doesn't fit. Whatever. It'll work. Yeah. Let's do it. I wonder what I'm forgetting. Oh, graphics card. Yeah, I'll figure that out later. Look at that. It looks like it belongs on there. It's literally just screwed in between the fence and the aluminum. Well, it's better than a rubber band, which was my original plan. And certainly better than the giant fan I had on there. I had a full size. Or not a full size. I had a, what is that, an 80 millimeter? Which just looks incredibly dumb. But yeah, looks pretty good. It's gonna sound like literal death, but it looks good. Yay.
I don't have a power switch on hand, so I'm just jumping it from... just taking it from this case. It's like jumping a car. It's nothing like jumping a car, but you know what? You like taking the keys from one car and using them in a different car. Except you have to take the entire key assembly. If key assemblies were easily swapped, and you had to move the... No, this analogy doesn't work. Nothing works if I don't turn the power supply on. I wonder which one... I assumed it was blue, because it's blue on the case. Ah! That's it. A fascinating sound. Both fans have spun up. The LEDs haven't come on though. All the fans have spun up and I'm not getting any error codes. I want to say this hard drive's running too. I think we just built a computer. Out of this. It's pretty too. The ketchup and mustard kind of isn't great for the aesthetic, but whatever. Wait a second, we should be getting error codes. Why aren't we getting error codes? Oh, we're not getting error codes because I never plugged in a speaker. You dumbass, Logan. It's important, TM. I have to Google all the connections on this board because I never took a picture of them like I really probably should have. I'm probably gonna... Is there one in here? Hey, there is! Look at that. You just... I hate Molex with a passion. Why would you zip tie that? Molex. It's a fan. Let me do that. See if we can get this. God, I hate Molex. Did I say that? Guys, did I mention I hate Molex? I don't think I've mentioned I hate Molex. Can't get that under there. Maybe I'll manage that at a later date, aka never. Let's do it. The fan is once again spinning up without LEDs. Hold on. Are they just really, really dim? They're gonna be blind. They're dim and flashing. Yes, I just punched it. Shut up. Alright, there we go. That's on. It's done. Ah! Look at that! Disk boot failure. Insert system disk and press enter. That is exactly what it should be doing. Alright, now I need... What do I need now? This fan is still doing the LED flashy thing. Now, just slam the fan into the chassis.
Nothing can go wrong.
Funny thing is, because this is open air, I'm just pushing two fans into each other. Like, it'll be fine. Everything will be fine. Never do that. Never do that. Never plug a fan in while the system is running. Ever. Don't do it. Alright, I need a power button. No idea where I'm gonna get one of those, actually. Do I want front panel USB? I think I want this stupid thing down here I took apart last night. Where is it? There it is. Little SD card reader thing, and it's got a singular USB port. USB 2. And I've got... USB header to USB header. It's cool, both of these use USB header to USB header. So it's pretty easy to plug them in. I want a USB header to dual USB, because then I can switch between one of these and USB ports outside my case, because I use one of these going out of my case because I don't have enough USB ports. It's really, really sketchy and kind of weird, but it works. The S340 has an included SD card reader. It has a few problems, one of which is Windows ejects the SD card reader when you try to eject an SD card. So you have to just, like, make sure it's not in TFS and make sure everything is closed. Or you have to eject it and then unplug and plug back in the header in the case. Which, that's fun with the main system. Anyway, I think I've told that story before. Let's get a keyboard. My camera's stupid, so I wasn't recording large amounts of the Sekvik saga, but basically none of the power switches I can find work. I tried to use this. This is actually a case intruder switch, but it's got a really long actuation. It's very satisfying. But it doesn't work. It's apparently not high enough voltage, and it just boot cycles if you try to use it or something like that. Something like there's still something in my Model M, and it's really seriously bothering me. So yeah, it's booting to Windows. I have a drive plugged in. It's kind of a pain to find to set the cable. It's getting devices ready because it was on a SATA board, or on a SATA. What? On a Dell board. Gosh darn it, Logan. It's not gonna have a fun time with this BIOS. Going from Dell to Gigabyte, I can't imagine, is particularly easy. Yeah, computer, it's running. I need a GPU for it, probably. Probably isn't gonna be functional. More importantly, it's functioning! How is it functioning? It caught fire! Clearly caught fire, how is it on? There's literal burn damage on the stupid flippin' PCI slot. And it's... it's working! Look at this! I don't know why this is asking for this account. Stop! Stop! Evidently, my memory card ran out of room, I lost my tripod, and there's a leaf vacuum outside, although you probably can't hear that, because I closed the window. Oh, there it starts up again. Anyway, it's done, sort of, ish. Kind of. Yeah, hooray. I've got... yeah, it's done. I don't really have much to say. I got a power button. I just robbed one from another computer. It was in a block style connector, so I cut up the block style and just, you know, it's just basically just a power button. And I guess there's really not much else to say. It runs Windows, okay-ish. I need a graphics card. Yeah, I'll do that sometime later. Can't really do it now because I don't know what graphics card I would put in it, because I have yet to benchmark all of them, and that's a big project that I need to get back to work in back to work on, I'm not going to try to finish that sentence because I have a feeling I'll just stumble through it a lot. I'll just stumble through it a lot more. I'd stumble through saying I'd stumble through something. Regardless, that's the end of this video, so, I hope you enjoyed it, and I guess I'll see you again sometime. I can't remember. Oh god.
Why am I laughing?
Because auto-cannibalism.